How to measure the distance and displacement, and we measure the distance and displacement in different situations, and also we compare that distance and displacement. And now we are going to discuss about, means we are making a solutions on distance and displacement. Let's make some solutions to make solve on distance and displacement. Let's we talk about each and every topic, the distance and displacement, how to solve by using solution. So to make preparation for our online test, come into that. Vector quantities needed. Vector quantities needed. Both the magnitude. Both a magnitude and a dash. What I'm going to ask you is not visible. Vector quantity, vector quantities, what I'm saying you need both magnitude and a dash. And one more to talk about that, which of the following would never take you? Which of the following is never negative? Which can not be negative? Coming to that, the unit for distance is, the unit for distance is, and the unit for displacement is. Okay, I'm coming to that. A person travels from here to B. A person travels from here to B. And again. And again, he travels from B to A. In this case, we have to measure what is in the current means one change. In this case, what is the distance and displacement? And coming to that, one more what you can say here. Talk about that. The motion of a freely falling body. What I'm saying to you? The motion of a freely falling body or object is in air, or object is in air. Is it visible to you? Yes. Coming to that, what I'm going to talk to you. See carefully, vector quantities need both magnitude and what? The physical quantity which is following both magnitude and direction, then we can call that physical quantity is nothing as what? Vector quantity. The vector quantity should follow both magnitude and direction. So here, vector quantity. which never becomes a negative, which never becomes negative, distance never becomes negative, displacement can be negative. Displacement can be negative, distance cannot be becomes negative, distance cannot be becomes zero, but displacement can be zero or negative. And the physical quantity which is following both magnitude and direction, those we call vector quantity. If the physical quantity follows only magnitude, not follows the direction, those physical quantities we can call as scalar quantity. So the unit for distance is, the unit for distance is, so in SI system, meter, in Celsius system, centimeter. Then as for that, what I say to you, unit for displacement. Distance required as displacement required as bar. So here the unit of following. It is in nothing but meters in SI system, centimeters in Celsius system. Okay? A person travels from A to B and again he travels from B to A. There are two situations, case 1 and case 2. See here, the person travels from A to B and he came back to B to A. See here, distance it will be something. Suppose if it is a 1 meter, he will travel to A to B. He will stop same 1 meter from B to A. Means distance is equal to 2 meter, length covered by a body. Then displacement is what? Final point minus initial point. So final point, initial point is 0, final point also 0. So displacement is 0. And also coming to that, if your body is projected upwards, if your body is projected upwards from A to B in case 2. In case 2. Once by traveling such a line, in this situation also, what happens? If it is 1 meter and 1 meter, distance will be 2 meter and displacement will be 0. Okay? Can you know what I am going to say to you? What we can say here? In these two situations, when the body comes from A to B and B to A, the distance is always greater than the distance is always greater than the is always greater than the displacement. What you can say? Displacement. Understand? Coming to that, one more what you can say. The motion of freely falling body or object is nothing else. The body which is freely falling, under the gravity, follows uniform acceleration. Not all that. Yeah, coming to that. Let's talk about someone. The car moved 80 kilometers. The car moved 80 kilometers to the south. To the south. What is the displacement? What is the displacement? See, what I'm saying to you, one more. The car moved 60 kilometers each. Clear? The car moved 60 kilometers each and 90 kilometers left. And 90 kilometers west. Okay? What is the distance? What is the distance? What is the distance? See carefully what I'm saying to you. The car moved 80 kilometers to the south. What is the displacement? The car moved 60 kilometers east and 90 kilometers west. What is the distance? The car moved 80 kilometers to the south. South where the towards the down. How will we discuss it? South the direction of India map. North, south, east, west. So towards the south, how much it is 80 kilometers it is moving? So it was started from initial zero and maximum is 80 kilometers. Displacement is equal. Displacement is equal to what we can say. What we can final point minus initial point. That means 80 kilometers minus 0 kilometers, we can get 80 kilometers. Displacement is 80 kilometers. Then a car moved 60 kilometers east. So by that, a car moved towards the east 60 kilometers. And 90 kilometers west. What about 90 kilometers west? See here, the car moved 60 kilometers from east, and from east to west, it moved how much? 90 kilometers. Means 90 plus, so remain how much? 90 means, see here, from here 60, and this is 40. Means to move by this 60, to move by this, what happened? 90 kilometers. The total distance covered by a body means length covered by a body. So what we can say here, length covered by a body is nothing else distance covered by a body. Distance covered by a body is equal to distance covered by a body is equal to what we can say length towards east plus length towards what we can say west. So by that what we can say, so how much that towards the east and the west, towards the east is the how much 60 kilometers and towards the west 90 kilometers. Then total how much 90 plus 60? 150 kilometers. How much? 150 kilometers. So the total distance covered by a So coming to the strength, what should talk about someone? What we can talk about? A car moves 3 kilometers each. A car moves 3 kilometers east. And what we can say, and 4 kilometers west. What is the displacement? The same kind of question. A car moves 3 kilometers east and 4 kilometers west. What is the displacement? Not west, south. Okay. What is the displacement? We can talk about not only south, east also not at all. Okay? East to north. Sorry, what was that? South or north. If it is east or otherwise, we can say west. What are the conditions we get? See that? What we are going to talk about, towards the east. East, this is 3 kilometers. Then it is coming back towards the west. This is the west. Okay, this is the east. So 4 kilometers from here, so it is coming to 4 kilometers. Understand? It starts from what is 0. See, according to the numerical line, 0, 1, what we can? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So it starts from the east and it is the west. What is from 1, 2, 3? So if it is from east, what is 3 kilometers? Then again, coming from 1, 3, 4. If it is from here, so means what happened? Final point is minus 1, initial point is 0. So displacement will be 0. Sorry. Displacement is minus 1 kilometer. Displacement is minus 1 kilometer because of final point minus initial point. Final point is minus initial point is 0, so minus 1 kilometer. Coming to here, the car moves 3 kilometers east and 4 kilometers south or north or always west. See, according to India map, all that we discussed, east, west, north, south. So towards the east, what happened? East. 3 kilometers. Then from that, if it is south, means it moves south. How much? 4 kilometers. It is a south, what we can say? South. And same as it is origin. Suppose if it moves towards the north. Sorry. This is the north. And if it is the south, means this is the east. How much? 3 kilometers. So south downwards. So, what we can say? 4 kilometers. Whatever kind of problem, the situation is important. So, both are right angle triangle only. Both are right angle triangle only. By taking close to that, what happens? So, we have to put sharpest distance. Sharpest distance is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is what we can find here. So, suppose see here, if it is ABC triangle, what is this? Is A, B, C. Of course, A, B, C. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Means here AC is the displacement. AC is the displacement. So coming to that, AC square, hypotenuse square, is equal to sine square 3 square, AB square is 3 square, and BC square is 4 square. So AC square is equal to 9 plus 16. So AC square is equal to 25. So S is equal to root of 25. So 25 has a perfect root 5 perfect square 5 kilometers. So displacement is therefore displacement is 5 kilometer. Displacement is 5 kilometer. Okay, not on that. Students, finish that. Let me talk about some more. Is it clear how to calculate the displacement? Then come into that. These type of problems already discussed. Okay? In our previous class, we already finished those. Let's talk about some more. What we can, if distance of displacement, if displacement of a particle, if displacement of a particle, is zero, what we can say here, if displacement of a particle is zero, the distance covered particle is zero, then distance covered. And coming to that part, I'm saying one more thing to you. The distance of your body is always the distance of your body always equal to displacement of the body in where? Where that is equal? Okay, coming to the ratio distance covered to displacement. Okay, then coming to that, 3 kilometers by 5 minutes is equal to how many kilometers per hour? See that once. If displacement of a particle is zero, then what about the distance covered? Distance never becomes zero. Is it or not? That's why what we can say, may R be zero. Distance covered. What we can say? May R be zero. Never be. Distance never becomes zero. The distance of the body always equal to displacement of the body in. When a straight line, when a body moving in a straight line, in a straight line, in a by motion. Means you can say rectilinear motion. Or we can say otherwise translatory motion. So when the ball is moving in time path, what happens? The both are equal, distance and displacement. The ratio of the distance covered to displacement. How do we finish it? You know that from this above situation, distance is greater than equal to the displacement. So what we can say by writing that this side means otherwise, what we can say is distance is greater than equal to 1 into displacement. So S by S bar, distance by displacement is greater than equal to 1. Means what we can say, it is equal to greater or equal to 1. The ratio of distance and distance covered to displacement. Ratio of distance by displacement. Distance to the displacement is greater or equal to 1. Greater or equal to 1. 3 kilometers per 5 minutes is equal to how many kilometers per hour? See that how many it will be? 3 kilometers. Kilometers is not a problem. So 3 kilometers by 5 minutes. See here, generally we know what we know by here. One thing see here, what we can, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So write in the minutes to hour, 1 minute is equal. 1 minute is equal, we can write 1 hour by 60. 1 hour by 60, 60 by transfer is this side. So similarly we can say, this is we know already. 3 kilometers by 5 minutes means 3 kilometers by 5 into 1 minute is equal to 1 hour by 60. So 1 hour by 60. 5 ones up, 5 ones up, 5 twos up. Means what we can say here? See here what we can say? 3 kilometers into this by otherwise by 1 hour by 12. By making reciprocal to that, 3 kilometers into, you make reciprocal 12 by hour. So now this is only 6 kilometers per hour. So by that, that is 6 kilometers per hour. 3 kilometers by 5 minutes is equal to 36 kilometers per hour. What is that? Make it fast. finish that. The player completes a circular path. The player completes the circular path of radius. The circular path of radius are in 45 seconds. In 45 seconds. At the end of 2 minutes, at the end of 2 minutes, 20 seconds. 2 minutes, 20 seconds. At the end of 2 minutes, 20 seconds, displacement will be displacement. Will be. See that there are two types of different situations in that a player completes a circular path. This is a circular path with radius r. Okay, he will finish or complete revolution, but if the path is moving by that, he will get 45 minutes. He will get 45 seconds we will take to finish one complete circular path. Suppose displacement covered by a player in to finish by player by finishing or by complete one revolve. What you can say, one revolution around the circular path. Around the circular path. See here, where it started from here, and finally it reaches the same of the position. The final point of position point both are same. So, what you can say, displacement is the zero. What you can say? Displacement is zero. Understand? Displacement is zero to finish one complete revolution around the circular path. Because the final point and the initial point are both same. Coming to that is not exact answer to that. They ask you once again, at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds, they are taking 45 seconds to finish one complete reverse. See here, what we can say here, remember one thing, the time taken by a player to complete one circular path. Is equal 45 seconds. What we can say? 45 seconds. Is it visible to you? Yeah, 45 seconds. Then, what I'm saying to you, then, how many rounds the player can make? Can make in two minutes. 20 seconds. 2 minutes, 20 seconds. 2 minutes, 20 seconds means how many seconds total? 2 minutes and 20 seconds. 60 plus 20 seconds. So is equal to 140 seconds. 140 seconds means he is taking 45 seconds to finish one complete revolve around the circle. Means how many 45 are there? Is that? See, once 140 seconds means so 45 for one round. Okay, seconds and rounds. So total 90 seconds and 2 rounds. Total 90 seconds, 2 rounds. So 90 subtract from that, what you can 0, 14 from 9. How much you can get? Suppose if you take one more 45 seconds. 90 seconds plus one more 45. So 5 and 13, 135. 135 seconds. So for 135 seconds, it is taking 3 rounds. What I'm saying to you? 3 rounds. Are you understand? 3 rounds. Okay. Then how much still is there? 135 you get out from that. There is only 5 seconds. How much there? 5 seconds. It is 2 minutes 20 seconds. 2 minutes 20 seconds. Within 2 minutes 20 seconds, how many rounds? After 3. So within 5 seconds, means how we can finish? See here. How we can finish? See, within 5 seconds, how it is possible to finish? Is it possible to make so much displacement it will be? How much displacement it will be? So coming to talk about that, how is this possible to run? 3 rounds, 45 into 3. For 3 rounds, 15 and 12 to 13, 135 seconds are going to finish. Just there is only 5 seconds. 5 seconds means for 45 seconds, they are taking one complete circular path. One complete circular path. They will finish only, they will travel through the diameter. When they will travel through the diameter? When they will travel through the diameter? Can you? See here, is it possible to talk about that? Is it possible? So within 5 seconds, suppose you separate 5 9s. Means what you can say? 9 parts you have made those. Means how I see one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 5 seconds means you have to make again half. So this is how it will be nine. Means from here to here 5 seconds is taken. So means the shortest distance traveled by a body. Shortest distance traveled by a body. So by the quadrant, so it is not a part of 5. Radius. If it is 15 seconds, what happens? It is possible to find. If it is possible to talk about 15 seconds, means how many rounds it may finish between 140 seconds, 140 and 15. So 15, so by doing division with those, 15 makes up 120. So remain how much is the 2? So 15 ones are, of course, we can talk about 20 seconds remaining there. Means half of it is going around. 2R is the displacement. So question will be 1 2R. Okay, coming to that, let's start another type of question to you. Coming to that, what I'm going to say, 1 kilometer per hour is equal to how many meter per second? 1 kilometer per hour is equal to how many meter per second? 1 kilometer is equal to how much we know, 1,000 meters. Then 1 hour is equal to 3,600 seconds. So is it? Of course. 1 kilometer per hour is equal to kilometer is equal to 1,000 meter, and hour is equal to 3,600 seconds. 2 zeros cancel. 2 5s are 2 18. So 5 by 18 meters by second. 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 by 18 meters per second. Okay. So keep in mind for your online examination. See you in the next class. Have a good day to you. Thank you.